Hi, I'm Tom.
I'm one of the assistants here at Pendleton Golf Club, and this is my explanation demonstration of a bunker shot. First of all, we know this is a green type bunker as it's a higher lip, a little bit more sand, and the flag is very close to us versus a fairway bunker, which has a lower lip, a little bit further away, and a little bit less sand in it. So first of all, the club I'm selecting for this shot, obviously you've got to select the appropriate club for the shot. So I'm going to choose my 54 degree sand wedge. This is because it's a higher loft and it's going to engage the bounce a little bit more as we're coming into the sand. So that's going to help us get this ball out of the bunker. Should be a, obviously it's green side, so it should be a short, high, soft landing shot with not much curvature, well zero curvature as it's a short shot. First of all, going to be looking at the aim. So the aim affects the club face, the centre of strike, and dynamic loft. So as we're aiming, we're going to be opening this club up as much as we can to loft this ball out of the bunker. We open this club up too much, pull this down slightly. If we open this club up too much, that's going to affect our club face aim. It's going to be directed too far to the right of our target. If I close this face down too much, aim too far left to the target, I'm also, that's also going to take the ball left of our target. As I said, it's also going to affect the centre of strike. We're aiming too far right, we can get the ball caught out of the heel. Vice versa, too far left, we get this ball coming out of the toe. So we want to try and hit the middle of the club for each of these shots, to control our distance, our trajectory, and our run on the green. If we get it out the heel, we're going to get a little bit more spin. If we get it out the toe, it's going to come a little bit more dead, so we're not going to be able to control that distance quite as well. It's also going to affect our dynamic loft. As we're aiming right and opening that face up, we're adding dynamic loft, so that's going to get us, we're going to have too much dynamic loft for the shot, vice versa. If we're aiming it left, we're going to be shutting that face down and taking all the loft off it and the dynamic loft off it. The grip or the hold affects the club face, the club head speed, and the dynamic loft. So we need to open this club up enough to get the ball out the bunker, so we're going to open this club up like so, and we want that face to be aiming at the target. We open that club face up too much, that's going to affect what the club face is doing. Again, it's going to be aiming right of our target. If we close that club face down too much, it's going to be aiming left of our target, which is going to affect where the ball goes. Also, if we have a strong grip, that'll close our club face down, which will mean as we're coming in, we're closing it down, we're getting a little bit too steep on it, and we won't be able to get the right angle of attack on it. Vice versa, if we have a weak club face, that's going to open that face up, and we're going to have too much loft presented at the ball, so the dynamic loft's going to be too much at the ball. It's also going to affect club head speed, so we want to be holding this club centre to bottom. If we have this club holding too high, our arc's going to get a little bit too long, and for this type of shot, we're going to hit the ball too far. The ball's going to go over the green instead of like where we need it, just landing softly on the green. If you have it too low down, we're affecting the length of the club. We're going to get a little bit more control, but not necessarily get the ball out of the bunker. So we want to be gripping it a little bit further down the shaft to gain control, but allow enough speed to get the ball out of the bunker. Right, so we want a neutral hold, not a strong, which will close the face down, or a weak, which is going to open that face up. Obviously that's going to affect where we're aligning to the target. Just to mention as well, when we're setting up, we want to open the club up first, then take our grip. If we set up to the ball square, so this club's 90 degrees square to our target, and then we open our face up, we're going to have a little bit of a strong grip, and that's going to shut the face down, encourages us to get a little bit steep on it, which obviously we don't want to take too much sand. We won't be engaging this bounce enough in the bottom of this club. Ball position, it's going to have a ball comes out. If we have our ball, we want our ball position slightly towards our left, our lead side. So with your right-handed golfer, that'll be our left side. Left-handed golfer, that'll be the right side. So that lead foot, or lead leg if you will, want that ball slightly favouring that side. So if we would have, this is our middle, we'd want just in front of that middle, just towards our left foot. If we have that ball position too far back, we're going to be getting a little bit too steep on it. We're not going to get the right dynamic loft to get the ball out of the bunker. If you have this ball too far forward, we're going to be catching a bit too much ground. It's a bit too much sand first, and we're going to catch that leading edge. So the ball position, that affects the angle of approach. It also affects the centre of strike and dynamic loft. So again, we've got our ball too far back. So this is our centre line. We have our ball too far back, coming in a little bit steep. We can also catch that ball out the heel. Like we said before, we want this ball coming out the center. Vice versa, if you have it too far forward, as we're hitting it, we're gonna catch the sand, we're gonna catch a little bit too much of the sand. We're gonna catch this ball thin out the bottom of that club, and that's not gonna get the right trajectory out of this bunker for us. It's also going to affect our dynamic loft. So again, too far back, too steep, not going to be able to get this ball out of the bunker. Ball's going to come out too low, and we're going to hit the lip of the bunker. Like I said before, that the lip's quite high on the greenside bunker. Too far forward, we're not going to have enough dynamic loft. We're going to be catching the bottom of that club. Centerness of strike isn't good. We're going to be catching too much of the bottom. Well, the centerness of strike could be good, but we're going to be catching too much of the bottom of that club, which is not going to engage the bounce of this club, which is why we chose the club in the first place. The body alignment is going to affect our swing path. So, like we said, we want to be our club slightly open and our body alignment parallel to hit the correct bunker shot. If we have our body directed too much to the right, our swing's going to be a little bit too much into out, which obviously then going to cause the ball to go right of our target. Vice versa. Also, we could be a little bit too shallow of that as well. If we have our ball position, if we've got our body alignment too far left, we're going to get a little bit out to in, we're going to get a little bit too steep on it, and the ball's also going to go a little bit left of our target. Our posture and stance affects the angle of approach, the club head speed, and the centerness of strike. So like we were before, our ball position slightly forward, our body and stance, we want to ingrain, make sure we're ingraining ourselves into this bunker. We don't have a solid base because it's quite a high speed shot, we're not going to be able to play this shot effectively. So we want to be making sure we're solidified into this bunker. We want a nice athletic posture. So get that solidified into the sand. Nice athletic posture. Weight on the balls of our feet. Nice straight back, bum out, legs slightly bent. Like I said, this is going to affect our angle of approach. If we have a bad posture, leaning too far over it, as you can see, my back's straight, but no knee flex. Out to in swing path, I'm going to get a little bit too steep on it. Vice versa, we're sitting back on it a little bit, weight's on the heels of our feet. We're going to get a little bit too shallow, I'm not going to be able to get down towards the ball. Like I say, we want nice athletic posture, weight on the balls of our feet, so that allows us to hit a nice bunker shot. It's also going to affect the club head speed. If we're like this, too much bent over, we're not going to turn properly, we're going to be getting a little bit steep, like we said, we're not going to be able to hit the shot correctly. If I have my weight too much on the heels, again, we're not going to get the correct strike on the ball that we need to get out of this bunker. And we're going to be a little bit too shallow of anything. It's also going to affect the centerness of strike. So again, if we're at weights on the back of our feet, we're coming here, as we're swinging this way, it's going to affect the centerness of strike. We're going to hit a little bit more at the heel because we can't get back to the ball, can't get that club centered and square towards the target. Too far over it, we're going to be hitting more of that toe, and that's going to be affecting that direction as well. So if we're too far back, going to be hitting it too far right, we're standing too far over it, that's going to be affecting the strike at the toe, and that's going to go too far left. Like we said before, the heel and the toe strikes affect the curvature on the ball. And as we said at the start, we don't want much curvature on this ball at all. So just to go through, the arc of our shot dictates how far this ball goes, so the length of swing. Ideally for this shot, we want an L between that left arm and the hands and the club on the way back. Also creating that L on the way through, between the arm and the club on the way through. That's going to help control our distance. If we go any further, that's going to get the ball going a little bit too far. Anything shorter, we're not going to get enough speed to get the ball out the bunker. We want to generate that speed on the downswing to get the ball out the bunker. Like we said at the start, we want to hit this ball. We have this, we have our ball position. We also, just to mention, which I forgot, the ball position is forward. Body alignment square to our target. Posture and stance, we want it 60-40 favouring that left side, so we can produce an in to square to in swing path. So just to go through, we want to take our aim square to the target and our body square to our aim. So we want to open that club up a little bit, aim at the flag, then take our aim, align our body slightly left parallel to that target, so everything square to the target. Grip and hold, slight neutral, slightly towards the bottom of the club. Like I said, body alignment left, and a nice 60% on that left side, favouring the left side. The weight distribution and 40 on the left. That should produce, hopefully. Bunker shot, that'll be able to get us out with bunker, like so. As you can see, didn't take too much sand, didn't take too little. Ball came out nicely, nice straight flight. Zero curvature, and we've safely got ourselves onto the green. Hopefully, ready to hold that putt. Thanks for watching.